So here we have four samples. Well, there are actually eight data sets because it's paired end data. So you can see this is sample one, this is sample two, this is sample three, this is sample four. And the only thing that sets them apart is these F or R's. F stands for forward reads, R stands for reverse reads. And when we analyze things like this, we usually want to do the same thing to all of them. So instead of doing this one by one, we can combine them into something that in the Galaxy world we call collections. Let's do that. So you click on this button, you select all data sets in this case, and for all eight selected, you build list of data set pairs. This will bring up this interface. And here Galaxy is confused because it doesn't know where the forwards and the reverse are. So let's give it a hint. So all forward reads start with underscore F. So here we go. All reverse reads start with underscore R. Here we go again. So now we can either auto-pair them or pair them one by one. Let's auto-pair them. Let's call this new collection data and just click create list of pairs. You can see that the original data disappeared. Well, it didn't get deleted, it just became hidden. But instead, you have this collection. And if you click on it, you will see it has four samples. And if you click on each sample, you will see it has forward and reverse reads. So it's a nested collection. It has two levels, really. The first level is the level of samples. The second level is the level of forward or reverse reads for each sample. All Galaxy tools know how to handle collections.